This is Guardian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news, intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversation. 96.9 FM. The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
From what day you may find out, certain people not like me. Everyone cuckers bag a thing now. Makes true me, I do it like Nike. But me not fear no guy now. No matter how hard them a spite me, me just a go and do me thing now. Me just a do it like Nike. 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 Me just a do it like Nike.
Talking Heads with Naughty is brought to you by AML Foods Limited, the Bahamas Out Island Promotion Board, BTC, Burger King, the Cancer Treatment Centers of America, the Cleveland Clinic, Dunkin' Donuts, Fine Threads, First Caribbean Bank, Freeport News, John's Department Store, Joker's Wild, KFC, the Ministry of Aquaculture Marine Resources, Naughty Johnny's, Perseus Island Games, Scotiabank, and Tropical Gyros.
Tough. How much I stress a her and me rinse up. Okay. From what day you may find out, certain people don't like me. Everyone cock a smack a thing now. Bets throw me, I do it like Nike. But me not fear no guy now. No matter how hard they must fight me, me just a go and do me thing now. Me just a do it like Nike. 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 Me just a do it like Nike.
Me tell you the truth, if I were you, then me probably woulda like me neither. Fresh to the town, born again. Them said the flow ungodly. My mind need Jesus. Girls call cookies when my mind need reefer. Girl, when my frosting can't stand me neither. Aim excellent, point blank. Tell the truth, bullets never miss the chin like a Chinese teacher. Yeah, every bad mind fraud them is this. Them parents get corrupt, so them are negative. How much longer you got yet for people? You know, see you now benefit. These cars are digits. And say,
from what day you may find out, certain people don't like me. Everyone talk a smug a thing now. Big throw me, I do it like Nike. But me not fear no guy now. No matter how hard they must.
The Tuesday, August 22nd edition of Talking Heads is on and popping. Your boy Naughty and your company right up until 6 p.m. Phone lines are open today. We got a special guest, Toby Smith. We're going to jump right into the conversation in short order. I just got to remind you how you can chime on in. 323-6232, 325-4316, 325-4259 in New Providence. Toll free in any one of the family islands. 242-300-5720, 242-300-5720. Text lines powered by BTC, 422-GR96, that's 422-4796. Stream us live, take us wherever you want to go, guardiantalkradio.com, that's guardiantalkradio.com. Cable channel 969, BTC flow channel 612. That's how you get it in, that's how you get it on for fresh new smart talk all day right here, Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. All right. We got lots to talk about and special guest today. Glad to catch up with him. And of course, you know, normally we do the Grand Bahama Report on Tuesdays, but both Sarah and Darren are traveling. So I bid them safe travels and I do well in both of your endeavors where you're going and enjoy. And we'll see you next Tuesday. And I always appreciate their contributions. But we got Toby Smith here today. No stranger to the show, no stranger to me, as you all know. And glad to catch up with him because, Toby, good to see you. It's been a minute. What's going on since the last time we talked?
Oh, a lot's been going on, Naughty. Thank you very much again for having me on your show. I appreciate it.
Good afternoon to you. Casa, you know,
muy bien, compadre. Gracias.
Cógelo suave. Now, listen, I see, you know, everybody, you know, I see the big three letters. Approval. Let's make it happen. What happened? Let's cut right to the chase. What happened to my boy? What happened to the BAM? What happened to the small man?
Yeah, well, I mean, I am small, but I've been approved. I got approval 5 years ago.
That's what I said.
They approved the project. The Bahamas Investment Authority sent me a letter back in like 2018 saying my project was approved. And since then, they're moving along like it's approved. But yeah, I see on the front page of the Guardian this morning, one in standard. Mm-hmm. You know, the same standard applying. Let's apply some standard. That's a very good word to be using, and it's very hypocritical of RCL to be coming out looking for standard. I called in the show earlier on. And I asked them, how is it that they could have these foreign workers pouring off their ships in Coco Key when I spoke with the director of the Department of Labor, he said that every single one of them is supposed to have a valid work permit and make contributions to the National Insurance Board. So when I asked it on live radio this morning, Philip Simon, the new, what do they call him, king, royalty, whatever they call him over there, he said that it was answered within the DEPP questionnaire and to refer to their 200-page report. But, I mean, he was on the radio. He could have just said how they go about, what loophole, why is it that Bahamians are only just being pushed aside to clean toilets and could do menial tasks? Why can't Bahamians fill every single position over on Coco Key?
Now, that's a question that, and Mr. Philip Simon, his actual title, he's the Royal Beach Club president.
Royal Beach Club. Okay. All right. Go.
Sure I give him his proper,
Okay.
Now, here's the deal, Toby. My question, and this stems back for years, and then a lot of people will say, well, why you could ask this question? Because I knew it. I grew up. I lived it.
Yeah.
And long before a lot of these cruise ships came to the private islands.
Right.
They came to a couple of well-known captains in the area, Bahamian, and a certain cruise ship captain off the Emerald Seas, because you've been traveling these waters at that time for already 20 years, and
back then.
No problem. They identified islands in the Barrier Islands, Coco Key, Little Stirrup Key, in that chain.
Yeah.
And for years, I would go on the Emerald Seas, and I know, because I was the cruise ship brat,
right.
I would go over on the tenders.
Yeah.
Stealing food.
And see what's going on.
And get there early.
Yeah.
Set up and do my thing. And right. I know, back then,
What thing was you doing?
Well, you know, exploring the island.
Oh, okay.
Getting into mischief. Working on my naughtiness.
Yeah.
You know, as a child, you just sit there and you think that's status quo, you know. This is what you do.
And you're innocent in watching it.
Exactly. But as an adult, then you ask questions.
Right.
Because when you start to take into consideration work permits,
yeah,
and in certain areas, and certain other businesses have to go under those guidelines, why is it that week in, week out, this happens? I say it's just some unwritten rule in the cruise ship industry between the Bahamas. It's going to happen.
Well, just like a nod.
Because it's been going on from time immemorial.
It has been. Or is it just hidden with some untransparent document like a heads of agreement that gives them it, and they're just not prepared to be transparent with the Bahamian people in saying, hey, yes, RCL have signed a heads of agreement that allows us to bring whoever we want off of the ship and not have a work permit.
And I get there are components when you're dealing with cruise ship passengers and you have certain activities on the island, that maybe you want certain people from on board to deal with certain things.
Like cooking a burger?
No. I'm talking about your water sports, your activities, your entertainment, because of...
What water sports do Bahamians not know?
I get it.
What cooking do Bahamians not know?
No.
They found a Bahamian...
Hear me out. Those kind of jobs, you know, waivers assigned or whatever, I could give like the benefit of that too. But to your point,
yeah,
cooks...
Yeah.
Busboys.
Yeah. Bartenders.
Entertainers, singers.
Everything could. And why aren't they? Because they won't pay a pittance.
But that's a start. At least make that attempt.
That's what they're doing. Since they blew the whistle on them, they haven't job fairs. They're trying to get as many people there on the RCL Facebook page saying, oh, look at this chef we just promoted to executive chef of the Bahamian. They bragging about an engineer that's been over there for, what, 5-10 years? This foreign. Why in 5 or 10 years can't they hire a Bahamian or have a Bahamian in training that's taken that position years ago to be head of engineering in these places?
All right, let me.
Right, but then they say on this morning show, right? They say, oh yeah, we want to make it all Bahamian, but you know, we might need to bring in some specialists, right? But then in what they said before in their presentation, and it has it here, economic impact goal. To be 100% Bahamian within 5 years of operation. Okay, so you got your little caveat there. Oh, yeah, we want to be Bahamian, but they're actually not. Oh, I'm falling for that. Paradise Island Lighthouse and Beach Club will be 100% Bahamian. Bahamian owned, Bahamian operated, Bahamian employees. Everybody will have legal status. Right, everyone will pay NIB.
Let me ask you this. And full disclosure, I know you. I know Mr. Simon. Okay?
Mr.
Simon.
Yeah. I know Simon too.
And I'll be honest with you. maybe by his him given that position as president of the beach club, that's a start of Bahamianizing.
Yeah, maybe
and
so.
And maybe as a Bahamian, he will ensure over the 5 years that it becomes Bahamianized as it should be.
Right.
But isn't it in the embryonic stages right now? They haven't developed. They haven't gotten anywhere. So obviously, they're going to start up doing what they know.
Naughty, hold on. They bragging about coming to the Bahamas since the 70s for the last 50 years coming to the Bahamas. This ain't no Johnny come lately in exploiting the Bahamas. They've been exploiting these private keys since time. And when you realize that on the private keys subject, right, you've got Disney, they've got Castaway Key. They've got Bimini, which is Capo over there in Bimini with the Bimini World Resorts, correct, right? As a private island excursion that people could do. You've got Great Isaac Key. You've got Little Isaac Key. You've got Princess Keys, Half Moon Key. You've got Disney putting in a new place in South Eleuthera, destroying Lighthouse Point. You've got a new one they're proposing for Long Island. And until Bahamia and Carnival are doing another one in Grand Bahama, until Bahamians wake up and understand that there's 10 private islands where then the cruise companies, they're spending a little bit in fuel, leaving from South Florida to come over here, there'll be no need to come to Nassau. And that's the direction that they're moving towards. And they're making cruises. ACL now says, oh, we love the Bahamas. We come to the Bahamas all the time. Yeah, but they're going from Port of Miami, a day at sea, a day at Coco Key, and straight back to Miami. They say and they love the Bahamas, but they're making sure where they go is that they're getting the top line revenue on a vertical revenue stream where those tourist dollars that are getting spent to the Bahamas aren't even coming to the Bahamas. They're going straight out the country for a corporate American greed.
All right. Now, they say it's, according to that plan, they say it's 5 years for Bahamianization. So you got it remains to be seen.
Yeah, maybe it's 5 years for Coco Key too.
All right. Let me ask you this. As far as your entity, as far as your project, as far as the Lighthouse goes.
Yeah.
At what point, and I get you fighting a good fight.
Yeah.
At what point do you just break bread and make sure that your operation goes?
At the point,
get it Bahamianized and we make it happen.
All right, so
make it a blueprint for that kind of operation, with full Bahamianization.
Right, that's what I've been promoting from the very beginning. This is
so maybe you could be the catalyst to get them to do what they need to do.
That's
because obviously, as a neighbor, you'll be fully operational and fully Bahamian.
That's what I'm trying. So what I'm trying to do is be able to get up and running. I mean, come on, man! I've been waiting. I'm in my 12th year. Let me get up and running and let me show people what we could do as Bahamians and have a whole out-island experience 4 minutes away from Nassau with Bahamian architecture, Bahamian food, using local wholesalers, using all the talent that exists in the Bahamas to show on a global stage what Bahamians can do when they're given the opportunity, instead of us standing around waiting for some approval or someone having their foot on our necks and not allowing us to do it. It don't matter if you're rich, poor, whatever, you still got to go through a process and it's still wait in line. So yes, I would like my project to be a blueprint. I would like it. So what's it going to take? It's going to take RCL to formally concede that they're not going to invade over the land that the government have made an agreement to lease to me. Right? So the government, under the minister's administration, agreed to lease me 5 acres, 3 of which is the beach parcel. RCL apparently got a lease for 7 acres. Within their lease, it doesn't describe where the land is, nor is there a site plan at the time of them signing the lease. People that signed, notarizing the lease, are saying they didn't sign it. So what's it going to take? It's going to take RCL, who are still uttering a 7-acre lease, 3 of which acres are in conflict before the courts, for them to formally relinquish back from those 7 acres to 4 acres. That's what it's going to take. I drew a line in the sand, and until they back off, then I'm going to keep coming at them like a pot cake and just be right there. And I've reached out to Michael Bailey. Michael Bailey said reach out to Philip Simon. I reached out to Philip Simon, and between the two of us, we haven't met yet. But if they're going over to PI and they're sitting on land that's contained within the lease agreement that I had and saying that they own that land and that they own that land out to the lighthouse, then they're being conflictual in what they're telling the Bahamian people in public. They're being confrontational. They're being provocative. And I'll react to that and I'll give them what's just deserved.
Are you willing to break bread? Are you willing to
work? I told them that from when they first came barging into town. Oh, this ours. No, it ain't. Get to know the story. Learn some facts of what's going on over here. They didn't. They barging in and they're like, who are you? So Michael Bailey, I said, let me meet with you. He sent his henchman. He sent Russell Benford, right? Then he sent Jay Snyder. Then he's sending Philip Simon. No, man, I ain't got time for that. If they want to have a constructive meeting, tell me who's going to be at the meeting and what their agenda is. If their agenda is that the two of us go to the Prime Minister and say, kumbaya, we've sorted out our differences, let Toby go on his way, great. Great, set me free. Let me do my thing. Bamians right. know how to do these things.
All right. I got some texts coming in.
Yeah, man,
for you.
Go for it.
All right, so, Mr. Producer, let's get to the break. Get the freshman out of the way. And then on the flip side of the break, we'll jump in, we'll deal with the text, we'll take some calls, and we'll continue the conversation with Toby Smith as we continue the Tuesday, August 22nd edition of Talking Heads, which continues right after this.
Ready for something very delicious this summer? Introducing the new Dunkin' Strawberry Cheesecake Iced Latte. Enjoy the bold flavors of Dunkin' Espresso and sweet, luscious strawberry, all topped with velvety whipped cream and irresistible cookie crumbles for a match made in latte heaven. Make Dunkin' Strawberry Cheesecake Iced Latte your go-to beverage this summer. The Bahamas runs on Dunkin'.
Shavara Roka Enias, Chick Cherney Farms. I don't think I chose farming. I think farming chose me. Winning this award will definitely give us the funding that we need to start our farming season. Most persons who are in the agriculture field realize that at the start of the season, which is in the next couple of weeks, you do always need a bulk of cash. I think we have a great track record for the work that we've been doing in agriculture over the last 10 years. And so when I saw the opportunity for an award like this, I figured, you know what? I should just go ahead and enter.
The Agrarian Awards, September 16th.
When faced with an illness like cancer, we band together, and we at Cleveland Clinic in Florida have your back. From advanced cancer treatments to extra safety measures at all of our locations, we're with you on this journey. For every infusion and follow-up, for every step of the way, for every care in the world, Cleveland Clinic in Florida. Get the care you need when and where you need it. To learn more or connect with a local representative, visit clevelandclinic.org/Caribbean.
Put your best foot forward this school year by shopping at John's for your back-to-school foot care needs. From toddlers to college students, have your child looking smart in a pair of Hush Puppies, Sperry, Easy Strider brand styles, and many more. Durable and sharp, the kids will step with confidence all year. Need socks and a belt? We've got you covered. And don't forget a new backpack and lunch containers. You can find all this and more at the best prices and customer service in town at John's on Rosetta Street and Carmichael Road. John's, we put fashion at your feet.
Tired of paying too many bills and loan payments each month?
Shrink your monthly debt payments down to one easy payment with our debt consolidation loan.
It also has a built-in savings that pays you 5% interest.
Inquire about our debt consolidation loans today.
Call 356-7764.
Attention all KFC lovers! Are you ready to get crazy on Tuesdays? Now you can get 5 juicy mouth-watering pieces of KFC chicken for only $10. It's crazy! 5 pieces of world-famous KFC chicken, handmade with a secret blend of 11 herbs and spices for only $10. Don't miss out! This crazy offer is only on Tuesdays and only at KFC. KFC Nassau. It's finger-licking good.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
We're back at you on the Tuesday, August 22nd edition of Talking Heads. All right, Toby, we'll pick up the conversation you and I in a minute, but I got some text for you.
Mm-hmm. Before we do that, can I send out a couple of shout-outs, please?
Uh-huh.
I'd like to send a shout-out to the fire brigade here in Nassau. Uh-huh. I witnessed them. I was just heading up Bilney Lane the other day, and I saw that house was on fire. So big out to the firefighters out there in Nassau.
Doing that thing.
They were in that building with a breathing apparatus. I mean, searching for whoever could be in there. You know what I mean? I can't say big out to the firemen in the outhouse because they probably don't have a fire truck.
Right.
But big them up anyways.
They have fire squads down there.
Fire squads, right. You got your squaddies out there. And also, Perry, if you're listening, Dino, Keisha, Bianca, I'm sending shout-outs to all y'all, too. Thank you.
There you go. But you got your support group for sure. Okay. Here we go. Naughty, I could feel the passion of Mr. Smith. I pray that God exposes the crookedness. Here's another one. Naughty. Ooh, just a long one. All right, here we go. Naughty, I really hope the Bahamas is listening to Toby and wakes up. This is one brilliant man that is paying attention and holding the government.
I'm far from brilliant.
I went to school with this individual.
Yeah,
sorry.
I'm not brilliant.
Brilliant. Sorry, let me start again. This is one brilliant man that is paying attention and holding the government's feet to the fire. What has me upset is Toby is Bahamian and he's fighting for us. But if he was a foreigner, they would have approved him a long time ago. That is what's most ridiculous.
Yeah. So they get the red carpet, they get the white gloves, and obviously treated like royalty because they're, you know, over here like they're royal.
All right, let's go to the phone lines. We have a caller, Talking Heads, Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Who's this?
This is Naughty.
Hey, what's going on, 52?
Yeah, blessed Toby.
Blessed afternoon,
52. I was doing my talking today. You know, I was on fire today, right? So I just called the big up Toby and let him know I appreciate his selflessness. You know, this is a selfless agenda.
And, thank you.
I thanks for educating me. Some of these kids in these islands, you understand what I'm saying? You know, Isaac Zuma boy, but you know, I know a lot of them, but Toby seems like he know all.
I've been down in Zuma week before last, my brother.
Thanks for educating me on the keys up in the north there and what's going on around. And, you know, I don't be many people, I mean, really know some of these kids. Let's be honest, Naughty.
Yeah,
let's be real.
Toby,
yes,
I want you to know, I share the same sentiments as the last text. I'm listening to you. And so, you know, of course, well, I mean, thanks for being humble, right? But, you know, I the same way, but you're very intelligent, my brother.
So
and
are you.
Thanks for enlightening the beaming people. And thanks for standing with us. And thanks for your disclosures, my brother.
Please, I really appreciate your call, and I appreciate the compliments. And that's a very valid point that
I've been
standing.
I got to go before I go, though.
Yeah.
After your disclosures, right? Because I know some people who work on Castle Ricky, and I'd call about a year ago and disclose some information that was going on there as far as environmental breaches, anthropogenic activity.
Right.
But then I'm vexed with the name Castaway because they've cast us away. Give thanks, man.
Yeah, man. There you go, 52. Always a good contribution from
always, man. You're highly educated, my brother. You always sound very professional. You on point. You do your research. And the point that I embellish on that is that, yes, I'm standing with Bahamians, not standing up in front, behind, we standing with each other that we could go about getting change.
Let's go back to the phone lines. Talking Heads, Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Who's this? Turn your radio down for me, please.
Radio's down. Good afternoon, Naughty.
Hey, what's going on, Sparky?
Good afternoon, Sparky.
Good afternoon, Toby.
Hey, what's going on, my brother? You all right?
No, Naughty, this might sound like it's coming out of left field, but, you know, the field have all different sides. What I see happening again, as I see the elites fighting among themselves, these foreign companies like Royal, whatever the shipping company name, don't they have to have Bahamian lawyers, Bahamian accountants doing their work in the Bahamas?
So they've hired a bunch of foreigners on their disclosure.
No, I mean, they're a foreign company, but when they're operating in the Bahamas, don't they have to have a backside with Bahamian lawyers and Bahamian accountants doing?
I know about accountants, but I know that they got a Bahamian lawyer.
Yeah, but what I'm saying, when I say I see the elites fighting against the elites. Like, you're fighting against them, although you already had your approval and so forth.
Yeah.
But I see Bahamian lawyers making their money from these companies.
Oh, yeah, man, yeah.
So what I'm saying is, the Bahamian lawyers trying to make, that's how they make their money, by doing legal work. Accountants make their money by doing accounting. Mm-hmm. They don't care if they're doing it for you or they're doing it for Royal Star Caribbean.
I respect that.
And then you trying to make your money because you had this grand idea.
Mm-hmm.
So what I see is the elites fighting against the elites, but I don't see nobody really caring about the Bahamian people.
Well,
fighting for the people over the hill.
I fight for everybody. Over the hill, under the hill, Mason
Toby, edition. Toby, listen to what I'm trying to say. At the bottom line, no matter what happens, the Bahamian people, the only thing they get out of that is jobs, waiters, bartenders, cleaners, and stuff like that.
They
could be owning nothing.
Yeah.
The elites could be owning everything again, and the Bahamian people still ain't going to own nothing. They could get and the same jobs, just in a different venue.
I agree, and they got Bahamians so desperate that the Bahamian that are unemployed, that haven't found work for the last 6 months, a year, getting laid off from job to job, they're happy to take up on $260 from minimum wage. And I'm saying, man, that's absolutely, that's not a livable wage. People cannot live off of $260.
You think any of them people that bring the grand idea about minimum wage can live off of $250 a week?
No, sir, absolutely not. And that's absolutely...
Most of that is just their drinking money.
It's BS.
They drink more collect than that in a week.
That's right. And that's why, for me...
Light bill, water bill, and everything. The elites don't really care about nobody. Our religious leaders, our social leaders, and our political leaders, they just want to keep us happy. And happy is a second-hand car, a government house if you'd ever pay for it, and some grocery that you can't afford. Have a good day.
Have a good day, too.
All right, Sparky. When Sparky, keep it in time today, boy. I can't afford it. I don't think this is big enough.
My dose.
Talking Heads, Sparky. Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Who's this? Talking Heads. All right, call us back if we had you on hold too long. If we wasn't with your speed. All right, I got a couple more for you. Let me get back to the text lines, Toby. And okay, let's see. Where is it? Okay. Naughty, great show as usual. I always listen to Toby. Good afternoon, Toby.
Good afternoon.
But my question is, when is he going to blame the PLP? He keeps blaming RCL and the FNM. When is he going to blame the PLP? All of them have blame. When is he going to put it all out on the table and blame everybody?
Every single administration of government has the responsibility to the people of the Bahamas. And when the people of the Bahamas, through a democratic process, vote people into power to represent them, it should not be that those that represent the people, once they're in power, should forget who put them in there. It's the people's agenda that should be followed. And that's any
And they all made you promises. Let's be real.
Promises? Administration, promises are the comfort to a fool. They put this stuff in writing.
Not true, but when I say promise,
So if they're going to, it doesn't matter what administration. Let's put it like this. The current administration has every opportunity. They could say, Toby, we understand that you're appealing this through the courts, but you don't need to go through that because, look here, we're going to honor the agreement that we have for a lease. We're going to respect the fact that we offered you a lease, and we're going to respect the fact that that lease is a valid lease, and we're going to sign it, and you're going to be on your merry way, and I could be starting tomorrow. Actually, I'll start today.
But, you know... It's kind of reminiscent of Abaco. As long as you've been coming on this show, we've been saying the same thing, basically, though.
Abaco, look at the domes fiasco in the front page of today's newspaper,
I'm talking regarding to this as well, too. Let's go back to the phone lines real quick. Talking Heads, Guardian Radio 96.9 FM.
Good afternoon. Is Miss Green in, or has she left for the day?
Tom Green?
Aaron's been gone, man.
Oh, Aaron.
Yeah, you're a little late.
She's late. You got what time for show? 10 to 11?
Whatever you was on last night, that was a good party, because boy, I tell you, you're way late. All right, let's go back to the phone lines. Hey, that's how we roll in the 4 o'clock. That's how we roll in the 5 o'clock. Come on now. Who's talking that?
Ask the hard ones, Naughty.
Yeah, well, that's kind of a hard one right there, you know. But obviously,
no problem.
Obviously, you know, some people follow you, listen to your story. Naughty, I cry shame on these leaders who are treating Mr. Smith unfairly. Toby, God would deal with them.
Yeah, they could deal with them, and also a large helping of karma. And I've already seen the karma coming around. And don't forget now, there's a paper trail behind all this. And once you get to see the receipts and pull files and have the files on these people that are doing these kind of things, then I think that, you know, karma will come around even quicker. But I just leave that to God, and I really appreciate all the support that I've been receiving. I mean, sometimes now I'll walk into a restaurant and after people, hey, Toby, what's going on, baby? We pull in for you. So if you want to go back to politics as far as what's, you know, doing the right thing, I think that any right-minded politician has a great opportunity to throw their support behind my project, get behind it, and brag about it once we pull it out from construction into operation, and they can be proud of it.
I tell you. I look at this whole scenario, and what I want is a solution. Obviously, we know that the big guy isn't going away.
Who's that?
RCI.
Oh, yeah.
And the little man ain't going away.
Yeah.
Because you got a lot of us little guys behind you to make us a big man, too.
Once they hear that clanging, they know.
So we got to make sure that at some point we get you all to the table and a positive outcome comes out of this. Because obviously we want to see you succeed.
Hmm.
Obviously it's a lucrative to the administration, so that's not going to waver.
Hmm.
But at the end of the day, I think you could be the actual blueprint to give the big guy an idea on how to do this right with Bahamians inside of 5 years.
So what other project have you seen that's Bahamian in the last 50 years? Name one. Not Crystal Palace, not Bahama, not Atlantis, no boutique hotel in the Bahamas. Right? Exactly. Yeah.
What is, let's go back to the phone lines. Talking Heads, Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Who's this?
Yeah, Naughty. Joe here. Joe from Freeport.
Hey, what's going on, Joe?
What's going on, Joe, my brother?
Hey, Toby, man. Listen, you got my heart here pumping, man.
Good.
You know, I think piracy is alive and kicking in the Bahamas.
What, like the Royal Pirates of the Caribbean?
Oh, well, I mean, all of the foreign entities are coming in and taking up all of our islands, all of our keys,
pillaging,
all of our seabed.
Yeah.
What, you know, 150 years from now, there ain't going to be anything left in this archipelagic nation that the ordinary white or black Bahamians can call their own.
So we haven't learned.
All of the keys between New Providence and coming up to Freeport, Grand Bahama, all of those keys in there are privately owned, either by cruise ships or individuals. You go from Nassau, going south to Long Island, between New Providence and Exuma, all of them gone. You know, Bahamians are met with sheen the guns on some of those islands if they have a boat problem.
Yeah.
And then you go after Exuma and you're going on to Long Island, all of those keys in there. And now they're scouting of even way, way down south, in Long Island and in all of those places.
Rum Key, they're looking at Rum Key.
When is it going to stop? It is absolutely criminal.
Why would it stop?
I blame every... I was going to use a word, but God help me, my brain...
Don't! Erica Dunhart with me.
No, and so when is going to stop? And it's up to our people. We are still friggin' after 50 years of so-called independence. We are more enslaved than we were under our white masters.
Joe, before you hang up, please, I got a couple of questions for you, right?
Yeah, go ahead, Toby.
All right, so in the Royal Caribbean-hosted town hall meeting that the DEPP participated in, RCL went on record as saying is that they are allowed to... So when they're in Nassau Harbor, they clean their exhaust. So the emissions going out aren't air emissions. They're cleaning that with our beautiful salt water, and they're keeping it and skimming off the all of the pollution. Not all. A lot of the pollution that goes out the stacks is going into what they call scrubber water, right?
Uh-huh.
Right. And you're familiar with the gray water from their sewer treatment and all the nanny they pump in overboard and whatnot. Can you believe, Joe, that they only have to be, according to RCL, they only have to be 3 miles offshore from a Bahamian island before they could start pumping out all that scrubber water and all that nanny and all the rest of it, right?
Excrement.
3 miles. Nastiness.
Toby and Naughty, that is exactly what is the basis of the criminality that's been done to our national waters here in Grand Bahama recently.
Yeah.
From the west, from Buckeye, the spillage, of course, that went all the way down towards...
And Uncle Joe, real quick, I don't want to interrupt you, but next week I need you to come on so we could talk in depth about those two spills.
Let me say this about what he's talking to.
No, perfect,
I worked for 8 years at the Grand Bahama Shipyard right next to Buckeye, and I had a bird's-eye view of everything that happened there. Why is it that this government haven't been able to inform the people yet? How come on the south side of Grand Bahama, inundating every beach for about 15 to 20 miles, inundated with oil, and we could easily find that out, because when those ships go up, they're supposed to go on international waters, yeah. and they slush out their tanks.
Yeah.
But they don't care about our national waters. They go right a couple miles off, and yeah. they do it out there, and that's why we had an inundation of oil upon our beautiful beaches on the south side of Grand Bahama,
yeah.
and we haven't yet heard a word from our government as to what the findings have been. And it's very simple for them to know how to do that, you know.
Yeah.
If they don't know how to do it, ask Joe Dowell. I'll tell them how they can find out exactly the tanker who did it. Very simple. Very simple.
I get.
And where is the national people, the Marines, monitoring the waters around Grand Bahama?
Yeah.
It's policy going on all over this place. And God help this nation, because
Amen.
If we go like this for another 35 years.
Yeah.
I could only plead.
We
no,
got,
go
we,
ahead,
we
go
got
ahead,
all the seagulls.
Why do you want to interrupt me?
Because
you're gonna have me next week.
I want to lock you down and make sure you're straight for next week. I want to check that day off the list. That's a big show. You know what I mean? I always like to chop it up with you.
You want me in Nassau, or you could do me right out of Grand Bahama?
No, man, we could zoom out of Grand Bahama. That ain't no problem, man. As a matter of fact, that's fine. Then you could bring me right up to snuff, because I want to talk about the two most recent oil spills. And what's going on with them, the past, or us building, and
well, you
what
know,
we need
the,
to do.
The poor seabirds now, I mean, thank God the birders of Grand Bahama, and also the BNT, Mr. Weir, they've been trying to clean up some of the birds. They were able to save two out of the three. One could not be saved because it was too much inundated. And those only ones that they found. Can you imagine all of those that sit on the water outside, cooling off, looking for their fish, and inundated with oil? They just simply sank in the water.
Nasty.
Or sharks ate them.
It's real.
I mean, you know, come on, let's
Sad.
Take care of this country.
Yeah, man.
God help our nation. Okay, go ahead.
All right, man. We know we got a couple other calls to get to before the break, Uncle Joe.
Yeah, I'll hang up and listen.
But
okay?
I appreciate you, man. We love you and be safe. Keep
Thanks,
keep,
Uncle Joe.
Love you.
Take
care. Toby, God bless you.
God
man.
Bless you too,
you
my brother.
You got more patience than Job.
Thank you.
You got more hair too? All right, let's get these last calls in real quick. Talking Heads, Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Who's this?
Naughty, what's going on? It's
hey,
Graham.
Hey,
hello, Toby.
What's up, Graham?
Hey,
make it quick for me, bro, because we got to get to the break. But go ahead, bro.
Well, y'all told me there's no oil in the Bahamas. Now we got low on oil. But let's move on.
Wait, stop it. Don't you go there with me. Anyway, go ahead.
You still didn't answer us on Equinor. Did it go in the water table? Did it go in the forest? And did it get washed back out to sea?
The goats
see,
ate it.
We're not serious about environment in the country, because every modern boat does some crazy stuff. And I ask a question now. Do we take plastics and macerate them? And do we put them in the water, the gray water? Do we dump that? Because if we do, that smothers the reef.
Yeah, and
it's
dumping
like
food overboard where it's toxic to fish. And like loud chocolate is toxic to dogs, they dumping that overboard and calling it feeding the fish like it's funny.
Yeah, Toby, so you know exactly, and anybody can go on YouTube and find out the environmental damage that a modern cruise ship does. That's all you got to do.
Yeah, and they greenwash over it. But you know also, Graham, right? The RCL will promote the fact that they invested in Grand Bahama Shipyard, but they're keeping quiet on that. They got a 40% share in Grand Bahama Shipyard. From the intel that I have, do you know that there's 220 expats that are working at Grand Bahama Shipyard? Why aren't they training Bahamians to do them?
Let me tell you something naughty. We brag about 7 million tourists. How come, with a big hotel and a big cruise ship, Abaco, without a big hotel and cruise ship, was one-third of the tourist dollars that stay in the country when it got damaged by the hurricane? How is that possible?
Yeah, sitting
at home. We're the modern-day slave labor.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
And now you're going to have a beach right there next to the cruise ship. So let me give you a scenario. In my head, could be wrong. You come in a lovely port, which is the city around the boat. You step outside. It doesn't look very nice. And you stay back in that safe area. And then you want to go down to the Tiki Hut, Junkanoo Beach, or the Fish Fry. But it doesn't look so safe, you know. But I can go right here to the lovely beach next to the boat. See, we don't see that beach because it's on the other side of the lighthouse, where it's nice and safe. And you'll have maybe a straw vendor and a fish fry person there. Our people, where it's safe. You never really have to go and catch a cab to go nowhere. See, we should have told, and I'll wrap up with this, Naughty. You made $10 billion in 2019. Huh? Here's what you're going to do. You're going to pay us 20% tax. Couldn't have done it without our country. And that's to help mitigate some of the environmental stuff you're doing and to put our people on your boat, environmentalists, to watch what you're doing. Secondly, we're going to fix from Montague all the way downtown under the bridge, down Bay Street, both sides of Bay Street, all the way to Chippenham and the Fish Fry will look like Marina Village with your $2 billion tax each and every year, 20%. You got nowhere to go that's this nice, that close to your origin. Secondly, Florida will charge you 30%, New York 50%. So your uncle, Graham, and Toby are going to treat you nice, 20%. If not, don't bring your boat. But see, that boat is useless without our beaches. And you all know it. And we need to negotiate like a boss, Toby, instead of some soup kitchen owner. Y'all have a good one.
Amen.
All right,
thanks,
Graham,
Greg.
Thanks.
Later,
all right,
buddy.
Listen, I got a couple of texts to get to, Toby, before we get to the final break. Real quick, everybody on Facebook, like the Talking Heads page on Facebook, like the page. And then obviously, you know, we post the flyers who's going to be on the show on a daily. Send your questions in ahead of time if you want to get them on there as well. We'll start opening up that platform as well to the show because I see a lot of people hitting me up and I see a lot of you hitting me there now. So if y'all are going there, that's fine. For those of you who don't know, go ahead, like the page, share the page, follow the page, Talking Heads on Facebook. And send me your questions there, even in advance, and we'll get them on there, all right? Hmm. All right, a couple more questions there, Toby.
Yeah.
I cry shame on these leaders who are treating Toby unfairly. Again, I agree. If he was foreign, this would not be an issue.
Yeah, give him what he want.
Toby.
Like FTX, right?
In regards to your point about Bahamian-owned boutique hotels, possibly maybe Island House?
Yes, the Island House and also the Landing in Harbour Island. Besides that, right, you got the Abaco Beach Resort Marina. There ain't many. And look how many, but look how many Bahamians are struggling, trying to get approval to say, give me a little bit of Crown land, right? I'm not going to say it, but I know a fella down in Exuma at a certain key who's been waiting, must see 50 years for Crown land. He's still working the key now, right? And it's extremely popular. Yeah, it's a beautiful place, but he can't build on it. He can't leverage it. He can't borrow with it. Because they won't give them a lease. When you want to bring up things like taxes, what Graham was saying, right? Oh, won't we tax these cruise lines? Yeah? If Bahamians are going to receive a tax, oh, we're going across the board, we're charging you 50% on tampons, right? We got to absorb that, no pun intended, right? Right. But you go try put a tax on a cruise line, cruise lines are like, no, we're not having it. We're going to need you to reconsider that. And then you see the government throw them a big party, right? Four meats, and they say no, we're not prepared to pay you an extra tax, and they say okay, that's okay, right? And then next thing, environmental inspectors. I asked at the town hall meeting what they do with their scrubber water. They say they pumped it in the Bahamian waters, 3 miles away from land, right?
Right.
Right. And I said, what records do you provide to the Department of Environmental Planning and Protection to show all of your records of what you're pumping overboard, right? Accountancy for all of your oil, accountancy for what you're doing, right? And the deputy director of Department of Environmental Health basically said that it's not his job, and me, as Toby, should apply to the Bahamas Maritime Authority, and I should ask them. So while Graham is saying that they should have inspectors on board these ships, that's how far away we are from monitoring these things.
God. Naughty and sad foreigners given more preferential treatment than Bahamians. When will the Bahamas be for Bahamians? When we elect people that realize the Bahamas is for Bahamians and we start being the conk.
Yeah.
Hi, Naughty. Is it strange that the contractor with the collapsed roof has a contract, but Toby, who signed and returned a written lease to the relevant government agency, doesn't have a contract? Now, with the roof, I hear it was allegedly, you know, a verbal contract. So if that verbal contract could fly like the roof did.
I don't think it was a roof.
It was a truss.
Oh.
Or okay. Trust assist.
Trust assist.
But all the trust is gone now in this administration after answers like that.
I don't know. I mean.
What didn't fall?
I think what fell, it wasn't supposed to actually fall.
That's BAMSI 2.0, all right? That got BAMSI 2.0 written all over it. All
over
it. I've
heard that reference. But have you? Do you know what's happening with BAMSI now?
I don't know, but I got to get this text in because this person is texting me like 3 times. Naughty, please read this on air. First of all, I'm a Bahamian woman, and Toby has my support. He's Bahamian. He's right. But more importantly, I've seen him out and about, and he has nice, nice legs. Praise the Lord.
Yeah, boy, check them calves. Boy, check them calves. You can make my gal jealous now, but I appreciate the compliment. Thank you very much.
Texter, you've made his day completely, because trust me, it's a little caucus. I ain't heard that in years.
Zoom in on them. And I stand with, I'm very inclusive in my hiring practices. So I believe in empowering women. I you know, not to exclude anybody. Yeah. And our hiring practices is going to be simply, are you Bahamian? Do you have the right to work in the Bahamas? And once you're qualified in your experience, then we're including. We're not separating out some people just because of what their beliefs are or whatever else. And it's about time that Bahamians are given a fair shake and a fair opportunity.
Appreciate you as always. You know, mi casa es tu casa.
Gracias, compadre.
We need to continue this conversation. We will until they get it right.
Yeah, man.
And hopefully next time, I plan to talk to Mr. Simon in the near future. And probably, you know, right after that, we'll get you back on. Maybe we get both of you on, and maybe we get this
both of us on. That would be a good show, man. I look forward to it. Or Michael Bailey, the CEO. I've been saying it for, years.
There you go.
Years. They keep blowing me off. But thank you, Naughty. Thank you to the Bahamian public. Thank you to all the support out there. I really appreciate you. And to those that are listening that can make a difference as far as persuading the government to say, man, let Toby get his fair shake, I appreciate you too.
All right, be safe. Much appreciated. Yep. As always, text us, call us, good stuff. And last one before we go, Toby, this issue reminds me of the of that fight for Clifton Key. All right, that's true. Another story for another day. Mr. Producer, let's get to the break. We get to the break. On the flip side of the break, we get into the 5 o'clock hour. We'll be talking sports. Pearly will be in the building. And we'll get into some good conversation. All right? And yeah, guess what? Argentina crying over spilt milk. We'll talk about that too.
And
I had to join Buddy Heal on the movement today. Yeah, and I had to do it in Spanish. We'll talk about that and much, much more on the flip side of the break as we talk sports as the Tuesday, August 22nd edition of Talking Heads continues right after this.
Get the flavor explosion that'll satisfy all your bacon cravings. The KFC Sweet and Smoky Bacon Sandwich from the Fried Chicken Experts features two crispy strips of bacon on a premium 100% white meat chicken filet, layered with two slices of cheese, smoky chipotle mayo, and our secret surprise, sweet bacon jam, all stacked on a buttery brioche bun. Experience the sweet and smoky explosion today, as it's here for a limited time. KFC Sweet and Smoky Bacon Sandwich. It's finger-licking good.
Cancer Treatment Centers of America is now City of Hope, creating one of the leading cancer care and research networks from coast to coast, providing more of what you need. More locations means more care closer to home. More specialists means more expertise. More research means more breakthroughs. More advancements means more treatment options. And more options means more hope. Learn more at cancercenter.com.
Refined style with elegant taste. The fine threads is your place. If you want those slots hemmed or just taking the waist, the fine threads is your place. If you want to look suave and debonair everywhere you go, like you're supposed to be in a video. Want to step out and look great? Then fine threads is your place. Refined style with elegant taste. Then fine threads is your place. Is your place. Is your place.
We're gonna give you a check every week for a year.
Percy's Pension Plan. Island game, keep you with it. Percy's Pension Plan. Dream big, we will help you live it. Percy's Pension Plan. Island game, we got you. Percy's Pension Plan. From the friends you can trust. It's winning is a must. Come play the game, you know, cause your best chance is with us. The most trustworthy name is Percy's Island Game. So put 20 on your account and ride this easy train at Percy's Island Game.
Okay, school bag, books, pencils, uniform. Oh, Lord. And I gotta buy snacks, too?
Just lay it on the line.
The Guardian Media Group and AML Foods want to help families in need with our first ever back-to-school snackathons. What's a snackathon? Well, we want to help by assisting in donating school snacks to children that may need them as they head back to school this year. To be a part of our snackathon, all you have to do is shop at your favorite Salomon Superstore or Fresh Market. At the store, you can donate your pre-existing loyalty points or you can donate cash directly at the register. Every single penny will go towards purchasing snacks that will be donated for distribution by the Bahamas Feeding Network and Hands for Hunger. Together, we can ensure that every child that opens their backpack this year will have a snack and a smile.
Get involved, get involved.
Ready for something very delicious this summer?
Introducing the new Dunkin' Strawberry Cheesecake Iced Latte. Enjoy the bold flavors of Dunkin' Espresso and sweet, luscious strawberry, all topped with velvety whipped cream and irresistible cookie crumbles for a match made in latte heaven. Make Dunkin' Strawberry Cheesecake Iced Latte your go-to beverage this summer. The Bahamas runs on Dunkin'.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Nassau, Bahamas.
Talking Heads with Naughty is brought to you by AML Foods Limited, the Bahamas Out Island Promotion Board, BTC, Burger King, the Cancer Treatment Centers of America, the Cleveland Clinic, Dunkin' Donuts, Fine Threads, First Caribbean Bank, Freeport News, John's Department Store, Joker's Wild, KFC, the Ministry of Aquaculture Marine Resources, Naughty Johnny's, First Seas Island Games, Scotiabank, and Tropical Gyros.
At you on the Tuesday, August 22nd edition of Talking Heads. And all right. Now, we're into the 5 o'clock hour. We got Pearly. All right, Pearly should be zooming in. Any second. I think he by the air fryer. He fell in for line today again, right? Yeah, you about the air fryer right now. You know that. After wake snacks. Hey, I was wondering what was going off all day. Mr. Producer, cut this phone off. I don't know this. I don't do Android, you know. And if you want me to cut this sound off on this, I might cut this whole thing off. You know me, I's a iPhone fool. And I won't kapunkle up the phone. Don't put that on me. But, I hear breathing by the air fryer. That's Pearly.
Yeah.
Sucking on a wing. Yeah, he's sucking on a wing. What was it? Was it a triangle or was it a drumming?
No,
come on.
I'm not air frying today. I'm hanging out with the most important woman in my life today, my baby daughter. So me and her are hanging out.
You hanging out with the boss then? That's the one who's be bossing you on Facebook. That's my girl. Tell Uncle Naughty say what's up.
Okay.
And keep bossing you to pieces.
The wave hand that you see on thing on TikTok.
There you go. That's all good, man. Better not to perish the loose, you know what I mean? And speaking of, happy 80th, Mr. Christie. Enjoy this and many more. Pearly, we got plenty to talk about, man. I can get today in sports history out of the way, and then we got to talk, because I hear we got a big injury. Stephen Gardner injured today, World Championships. Yeah, man,
he was
you see how bad he was beating them? He was destroying them.
Man. I mean, I think the whole country hurt. The whole country feel that.
Man, listen. Stevie is my boy. Stevie, all right with me. Stevie, listen. Stevie, we talking sports now, and I got on my comedian hat. Stevie, boy, when Stevie on, all right?
Yeah.
Boy, but when Stevie off, he's pull up more than a dancehall selector.
Boy, but he was looking good. He was really
man.
Different.
He was.
And damn, when he pull up, everybody, I think the whole country had a collective.
No, but I'll tell you something. Early on in our race, the runner from Ghana, from Africa, pulled up right out within the first 100. And then on that turn, I don't know what happened, but obviously it was something because every athlete knows their body, and Stevie went straight down. It wasn't no continue to try, run. So I hope it's not a lingering injury. I hope it's minor.
They have some of that, I mean, with hamstrings now, they like back in the day when we ran. They have so many technology, so much like electro technology, all kind of stuff. He's gonna be good. He's gonna be ready. You know.
But you know, you don't want to get that. Back. You don't want to get that knock of a history of soft tissue injury.
Yeah, like I said, they have the technology to work on that. You'll be ready for the Olympics. You can come back with a vengeance.
It's hot in Budapest. And that's coming in from a couple of texts. And it is. A lot of people don't realize that, but it is.
Dehydrated. He could have been dehydrated.
I know he had some issues in the prelims where he finished but had to be taken off in a wheelchair.
Yeah, but I don't want to speculate would go on. I can't wait to hear what the B3 is or what the team manager has to say or what he has to say.
Well, it was some sort of, to me.
I see him pull up and I concern.
Right. To me, I from all my years of watching sports, I see a track and field athlete pull up like that. It looks like a soft tissue. It looks like a hammy. And I'm hoping it's nothing else. Not a knee. Not an ankle. Not a high ankle. Not an Achilles. None of that. I'm really hoping it's in that hamstring, quad kind of situation.
It kind of looked like that. So we'll see. We'll see.
And maybe it's a quad. And if it's not a hammy, it's a quad. And that's just as long to recover. But I don't think it's long term, but hopefully, you know, a speedy recovery is in the making.
I'm sure he's young. Young people heal quick, so he can be all right.
All right, let's have a gander at today in sports history, all brought to you, of course, by Naughty Johnny's. And on this day, August 22nd, a couple of things happened. 1950, Althea Gibson became the first black tennis player to be accepted into a national competition. 1951, 75,052 people watched the Harlem Globetrotters perform. It was the largest crowd to see a basketball game. 1972, due to its racial policy, Rhodesia was asked to withdraw from the 20th Olympic Summer Games. 1989, Nolan Ryan became the first major league pitcher to strike out 5,000 batters. 2001, Brett Hull signed a two-year deal for $9 million with the Detroit Red Wings. And in 2003, Albert Pujols went 0-for-5 to end a 30-game hitting streak. Quote of the day, people say my ego is grand, but I think it's in proportion to me. Wilt Chamberlain, former NBA center. Well, it better be in proportion to other parts of your body, because I heard you said 20,000 women according to you.
I actually read, he said 20,000. But I was like, ooh.
Wilt Chamberlain,
he
boy.
He had many nights of seven sums and eight sums.
Wow.
Magic said in this book, over 2,000 women.
Man.
And I can't even claim 20.
Boy, Billy, are you even going there? I was just going, you should just left it right there at Magic. Magic is your boy. You only 1,980 behind Magic. Keep at it. You still young? Anyway, now that we got out of that, we get into, like I said, we started talking about Stevie Gardner. Obviously, we got that out of the way in the home court, what's happening on the home scene, the local sports scene, all brought to you, of course, by Burger King Nassau. And I'll be honest with you, Stevie kind of takes the whole cake. That just jumps to the forefront. But, Pearly, Andreas Nocioni. Why is Andreas Nocioni? Former NBA player.
No, before we talk about Andreas, I just want to shout out to Devon Charlton, who made it to the semifinals of the 100-meter hurdles and ran a new national 12.44 national record. So I'm proud of her for that.
Anything else on the track?
Soccer. She's a soccer.
Okay, and you're a sucker for sack.
She graduated from sack with my daughter, so.
Okay. That's right. Good.
So
you're such a sucker for sack.
He gets salty and catching feelings because we beat them.
Yeah, and my whole point is, you know, Buddy jumped in quick and hit him with the national three-letter symbol, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And hit him with the Bay and the Bahamian flag. I had to go in and brace him in Spanish on behalf of the Bahamas.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Because listen. How many times have we seen players with Euro backgrounds end up playing for Argentina in soccer?
Or players of African background end up playing, running track for you, Lithuania and stuff like that.
All right. So I don't want to hear nothing. And if your ma is a Bahamian, you could play for my team.
Ma born here.
So
this was something that the Bahamas was working on with him for a while, you know. I thought we had him last year, year before last.
And the whole running on about it is just ad nauseum.
So the point is, he can still play ball. The Americans don't want him anymore. So why shouldn't he play with us? You know the chip he have on his shoulder? What happens if Clay comes next year with us? He can be mad for that too.
Well, he could be hot with that. But that's race. Idadi is a Bahamian. So technically, Claire is a Bahamian anywhere in this world. Tell some administration do what they're supposed to do.
All right.
So I want to hear them say something about that.
We beat them. We beat them twice, the number four team in the world. So I'll be 57 after beating them, or 57 before beating them.
I don't know. I think we're 57 before beating them, so we got to move up.
Okay. We're number one in this region.
Yeah.
We're number one in this region.
And speaking of who your pa is, my good brethren, my schoolmate, my classmate, Mark Knowles.
Yeah.
All right. His son is an absolute stud. Senior in high school this year coming out. When you see that Knowles last name somewhere in major Division I football, because this kid is a monster, Pearly. He's 6'5".
Okay.
And he's a quarterback.
Oh, boy.
And he's struck people. And he got a cannon.
Okay.
Okay? So
he ain't messing with no tennis. He ain't messing with no tennis.
So my point is, when you see Knowles out there in major college football next year, yeah, that's Mark's kid. And ride hard for him, because that's another Bahamian on a major American gridiron who will possibly end up in the pros.
All those victories Ma gave us in tennis, we used to ride hard for him.
So we got to ride hard for Junior now, too. And especially if he catch fire and end up in the NFL playing quarterback. Can you imagine he end up playing for the Dolphins?
Of course. Shoot, it doesn't get enough Bahamian fans that I would probably triple.
Say he go 4 years in college. Two will be into his eighth season. Don't know how many concussions you'll have. Never know. Stranger things.
He'll spend a year or two on the bench learning the system behind Tua, and then Tua retires and he goes right
in. Better yet, he ends up a Dallas Cowboy.
No. Didn't want to do that. He'll be the second.
And I got to end with the Cowboys all over again.
We don't want to jinx him. No. We don't want to jinx him.
And then you win a Super Bowl too, and I could trot out in your face. Ooh, Lord.
Hey, one thing with you now, you could tell a good story. You make me almost believe you.
He's one of the best, buddy.
If I didn't know you, I would have been like, yeah.
I come from the West, you know. You better remember that.
That's why I say I know you, so you know.
Uh-huh.
I work on some people, some of the guys.
Somebody texted in and say, gents, 20,000, Wilt Chamberlain. Really? I don't believe that. And I bet you, Naughty, I hate Sock. I bet you texted, that's cool too.
But that actually is in Bill Chamberlain's autobiography or his what? Yeah, I think that's in the book that Bill wrote.
And apparently, you know, it's a good thing. It's a good thing Bill wasn't alive in the Me Too movement now, boy, because some people might have come after him if he had some money left. That's 20,000 divided, boy. Like, yeah, that's a lot to divide a couple million by, boy.
Yeah, sure, because he was making that kind of money.
Back then, but listen, Bill was a freak, though. They had a couple of... I saw a video of Wilt. He snatched the rebound, kicked it to the guard, and outran everybody up the court and flushed it.
Yeah.
I mean, he was an athletic freak.
He became a professional volleyball player after he retired from basketball, right?
Correct. The Mundo, and then made some movies doing martial arts because he was a black belt as well.
Yep.
So, yeah, Wilt did his thing, man. So, yeah, we got that to talk about. I still don't see why Nocione is just simply bitter, okay? And you know what I say in situations like that? Don't be bitter. Be better.
Yeah. Take your loss like a man.
All right. So Stevie went down today. That was tough. But
that was tough.
Devin Charlton doing her thing.
Devin Charlton moved on. That's right. She did extremely well. So I'm proud of her.
I'm proud, you know, and pick up
the... Did you see the women's 100-meter finals?
Listen here. Our girl from America, Shikari, boy, look here. Shikari wasn't playing, boy. Jungle.
Is that the same girl who got kicked off the team for a joint or something like that?
Yeah.
And they do a bad in the press?
Yeah.
She walked past all those press who did a bad and said, no thank you, and went to Jamaica and went to another brother.
Yeah, and guess what? I could be honest with you. She was like a pocket rocket. The ninth lane saved her in that race, and I'll tell you why. The two Jamaican runners, they were so consumed with themselves. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, they didn't feel it like that. They thought it was just them two battling.
And she baseballed in the two of them.
She sneaked them.
And that was good, too.
I don't pull for the Americans in track and field, but... Ever since the last of Karifta and me, my Jamaican, the Jamaican athlete is so cocky and so arrogant and stuff like that. I ain't pulling for them in track and field either. I only pull up for the Bahamas. And then any races, I just enjoy it.
Yeah, and I mean, I'll be honest with you, to tell you the truth. It was good to see her get some sort of vindication and redemption.
Yeah, I'm happy for her. I was very happy. She said, you know, she said, oh, what do you want to tell the world? She said, I don't, the world was good to me and the world was bad to me. I just worried about me. I get it done. So people who look like me can see that we can come back and stuff. She did a pretty good interview.
Now, listen, Pearly, as we slide, I got to add one to your list. And you know, I still will maintain, and I hope one day Serena comes back, right? So I go hold out my you know, sports crush card on Serena, all right?
All right.
And you know, I still got one for Winifred. But
Yeah, Winifred's your girl, yeah.
But here's one that you might like, all right? And her name is Alicia Baumgartner. She's a multiple world champion in boxing. And Pearly, she can fight better than the dudes, bro.
So I'd be like to go with her. She can beat up the fellas who try to mess with me.
Listen to me, though. I can be honest with you. I think women's boxing quietly is right up there now with men's boxing. Hear me out.
Pie beat up on a pie.
No, ain't no pie. So don't look for no too many pies. She's one of the few pies in boxing. What I'm trying to show you is they got the science down. Kind of like women's basketball. If you want to watch it fundamentally run correctly, watch women's college basketball. Watch one of the top five programs, preferably Connecticut, South Carolina.
Just watch Angel Reese.
Exactly. For Pearly's shameless plug, Pearly. There's another one of your sports girls.
But anyway,
my point is, just how they're fundamentally sound in women's basketball, the boxing, the science portion of it, the counterpunching, the uppercuts, the cutting off the ring, they've done a great job with it.
Well trained.
Yeah. If you like boxing and watching counterpunching and punches and combinations and stuff, women's boxing is solid. It ain't too much to look at. The landscape ain't too pretty. But if you like fighting, they got some good combinations and hooks and crosses and stuff like that.
You watch UFC 292, was it? You watch O'Malley beat the crap out of Sterling?
Listen to me, right? Paddy O'Malley don't play, right?
I look at him, I said, just do it. I said, but something don't feel right. I said, watch him put this boy down.
You're talking about Paddy the body, right?
Yeah.
No, Paddy the Body is the little British kid with the blonde hair.
No, this O'Malley.
This O'Malley.
Bantamweight or flyweight or something.
Right, and he got rainbow colored hair.
Yeah, but this one is all purple.
Oh, he was all purple, all right.
Or green or something. I can't remember the color, but it was all one color.
But he'd been fighting for a while.
And Sterling throw a punch and he duck. And he come up with him right cross and catch him. Flush. The fella said that was probably one of the greatest punches in UFC history.
I gotta watch it. Send me a clip if you got it.
I'll find it and send it to you.
This is a good text. Afternoon, Naughty and Pearly. Isn't there a rumor circulating about two brothers that play in the NBA who are interested in joining the Bahamas men's team because they may have ties to the Bahamas? We spoke about them yesterday. We're talking about Evan was a lottery pick out of USC, and Isaiah is in the league as well, too. Both out of USC.
Yeah.
Mobley, Evan played college basketball for the USC Trojans. He attended Rancho Christian School in Temuco, California. He was a five-star recruit in the McDonald's All-American. That's Evan Mobley. His brother, Isaiah Mobley, was
a... He'll be a plus.
And Isaiah Mobley, let me get you the scoop on him. He's with the Cleveland Cavaliers. Okay? So you have two. He was selected in the second round by the Cavaliers. He's 6'10", also played at USC. All right? So if you look at him, that's another big we could use. All right?
But I don't know if the rules would allow us to have all of them. We got Eric already. I think we only can have one more.
Ah, we got to look at that.
I think you only get up two people who have descendants, but everybody else has to be from the country.
All right. So Isaiah was drafted a year later, after his brother, and both play for Cleveland.
Both play for Cleveland now?
Yeah.
Okay.
So both of them play in Cleveland, but I'm saying, if you get two 6'10 bigs, bro, God, that, and put them with Ayton, poof!
Oh, yeah, that'd be nice. Or just one of them. We only could get one.
Just one of them. Get Evan. That's the NBA,
I think we can need more bigs moving into the next tournament.
We need more bigs.
So to say to bring, and I'm not against Clay, because I think Clay would be a great help, but to try bring Clay on, give me an opportunity to bring a big, I'd prefer to see the big.
I think it'll be easier to get Evan Mobley than Clay Thompson, because I think the NBA may block it.
The international three-point line is further away than the NBA or closer?
Closer, but...
Oh, Clay would kill people during.
But you know, now that Nocioni popped off, you may get other internationals saying, looking at this Bahamas team, looking at this a dark horse, and somebody who they don't want to play, especially if Clay is added.
Yeah.
There you have it. You got to look at that too, Pearly.
That'd be nice.
This where people start to play, you know, the cutthroat. This where it get like, hey, you know? Listen.
Hey, listening.
Text it and say, and this ain't your boy Rick either. Say that, Pearly. Say, Angel don't like the Dodgers. Nor are you, Pearly. Angel likes them.
Listen to me carefully. That messed up a good story with the facts, all right? Angel got a rapper boyfriend who got plenty of money. I got a million miles away. I can live in my vicariously through my, you know, dreams and hopes and joys.
These texts are cold-blooded, Pearly. You're part of the family now, because they're doing you like how they try to do me. So, yeah, you're totally official with them now. You're good to go. All right, so, yeah, that wraps up, like, the home court. Now we got to start looking at international. So what we're going to do, take that break. On the flip side of the break, we'll check out who's in and who's out. All brought to you, of course, by Tropical Gyros. We'll get our pro picks in, brought to you, of course, by the Island Game. And then, of course, the final 15 today, final 10 or 15 today will be by Rich Eisen. I think we'll do Eisen today.
Let's talk about the Dolphins as the front runner for JT.
Yeah, that's what we got to talk about.
Whoa, that'd be something.
Pretty, you get JT, you could jettison or you could trade off a lot of, you got some running backs going down around the league. You got some other teams looking for running back help. You could jettison Mostert and Jeff Wilson if you needed to, if you got Taylor. You could put one of them in a trade.
I don't know if they're one, not both. One maybe.
But you got to give up some picks.
Want a first round pick or a number of picks equivalent to a first round pick. So some people showing maybe a 2 and a 5.
I got one coming out of Dallas. I thought it was just bubbling. I called Todd Archer. Todd Archer says, getting some smoke, Naughty. I'll keep you posted. But apparently, Dallas might be dangling a player and a pick. And I'll tell you who that is after we come back off the break. All right? Well, keep it right where you got it. The August 22nd edition of Talking Heads continues right after this.
Grab your camera, capture the spirit of the Bahamas, and win cash and prizes. Scotiabank, in partnership with the Guardian Media Group, invites all youth, amateur, and professional photographers to enter the Celebrate Bahamas 50 Photography Competition, being held under the theme One Nation, One Legacy, Our Future. With more than $8,000 in cash to be won, snap those photos and send them in by August 30th. Visit guardiantalkradio.com or bs.scotiabank.com to find out how to enter. Let's celebrate our proud nation in photos. Terms and conditions apply.
Put your best foot forward this school year by shopping at John's for your back-to-school foot care needs. From toddlers to college students, have your child looking smart in a pair of Hush Puppies, Sperry, Easy Strider brand styles, and many more. Durable and sharp, the kids will step with confidence all year. Need socks and a belt? We've got you covered. And don't forget a new backpack and lunch containers. You can find all this and more at the best prices and customer service in town at John's on Rosetta Street and Carmichael Road. John's, we put fashion at your feet.
Hey, it's your boy Charlie Bahama, and let me tell you about a deal you can't afford to miss. It's the 2 Fly Free from Nassau promotion. You heard me right. 2 people can fly free from Nassau. Just go to BahamasResidence.com for all the details so you can start your vacay today. There are 10 participating islands with 35 amazing hotels to choose from. You can go to Abaco, Acklands, Andras, Bimini, Cat Island, Eleuthera, Harbor Island, Exuma, Long Island, or San Salvador. There's so much to do on all these islands, you just may want to go to a few. And why not? With the Two Fly Free from Nassau deal, it's like getting an island for free. Take your family. Go with friends. Arrange a fun out-of-the-box business meeting or retreat. Your co-workers or employees will love you. Or go on an adventure with the guys. Or a girl's getaway from the guys. Or a romantic trip for two. Whatever you do, you'll thank me. Visit BahamasResidence.com for more information. That's BahamasResidence.com.
Ready for something very delicious this summer? Introducing the new Dunkin' Strawberry Cheesecake Iced Latte. Enjoy the bold flavors of Dunkin' Espresso and sweet, luscious strawberry, all topped with velvety whipped cream and irresistible cookie crumbles for a match made in latte heaven. Make Dunkin' Strawberry Cheesecake Iced Latte your go-to beverage this summer. The Bahamas runs on Dunkin'.
As a parent and pediatrician, I know how important it is to keep our little ones up to date with their childhood immunizations. When your little ones are immunized, they have protection against diseases like
measles, whooping cough, and polio, which has
a treatment or cure. When the immunized child is exposed to the germs that cause these diseases, their immune system is prepared to fight immediately, preventing sickness and even death. Parents have been doing this for years to protect their children. Now it's your turn to keep your little ones safe.
Vaccines are essential for new and returning students. As you begin back-to-school preparations, ensure that your children's vaccinations are up to date. All vaccines are available at all public health clinics.
This message is brought to you by PAHO WHO, the Ministry of Health and Wellness, and USAID.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
We're back at you on the Tuesday, August 22nd edition of Talking Heads. And Pearly, let's jump on in into Who's In and Who's Out, all brought to you, of course, by Tropical Gyros. Boy, I tell you, brother, listen.
Uh-huh.
A lot of moving, a lot of shaking.
A lot of talking. I know, but the moving, a lot of shaking.
And let me remind everybody again, mentioned it earlier, today's Tuesday, buddy. It's Crazy Tuesdays.
Yeah.
Get those 5 pieces of chicken for $10 out there at the Colonel. Original spicy barbecue. All right. And hey, be sure to check them out on that new chicken sandwich there, Pearly. Have you tried that yet? Have you tried it yet?
No, I haven't. I haven't tried it yet. I went in the other day. I saw it. I went to get the usual 3-piece, you know, one 2 regular, 1 barbecue.
Man, you got to step outside the box, buddy.
I will do that on my next trip.
And next time, go, let me tell you.
I got a bunch of dining rewards. I need to cash in a couple of dollars off them.
But you ain't never near me with dining rewards, but I gunky in dining rewards.
Yeah. So my little $12 ain't plenty then.
Catch up. I wish I could use dining reward for gas.
But that's
sweet and smoky. That's what you got to ask him for next time, Pearly. Sweet and smoky bacon sandwich, all right? You got the chicken, the filet, all right? The Colonel style. You got the cheese, okay. The lettuce, tomatoes, the secret sauce, and you got the bacon on the bottom, and you got the bacon jam, all right?
Ooh, okay.
You got the double bacon slices with the bacon jam, chipotle mayo, all right? The lettuce, the tomato. Okay. Man, it's off the chain, daddy-o. I had 2 the other day. Not even playing.
I can try it.
Go talk to my people. See if I get us some coupons or some cards, man.
That would be nice.
Yeah. He let you love
yourself. Promise me nothing. I like them little German. Your promises I keep reminding you.
All right. Okay, good.
Like when you had the brother from Kalik on the show with me, who sponsored, promised to drop one of them independents. Kalik, can you reach out?
Big deal with him. Baker Mayfield. Don't worry, you mean for next independence. Listen to me. Baker Mayfield is now the quarterback for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Starting quarterback.
But don't be surprised if they don't pull the string for Trey Lance out of the 49ers. Because Trey Lance, he's the third string quarterback now.
Looks so to me as well, too. And again, Shanahan, listen to me. That dude, he likes a certain type of quarterback. I think he's afraid of a quarterback that could become a superstar. You see what I'm saying?
I think he's a fan of the bus driver. Purdy fits his bill of quarterback, what he wants, the way he plays, everything like that. Purdy don't hurt you.
That's right. Just generic. Middle of the road. Get you down the field. So, you know, we'll see what happens. Washington broke up Baltimore's record preseason streak. 24 games in a row they'd won. And they won 29-28. I guess Baltimore takes preseason more serious than anybody else.
Yeah, but that was a great game, you know. I really enjoyed that game.
But here's something that's popping out.
I don't watch preseason. I usually watch just the first quarter, maybe a part of the second quarter. I watched that game all the way to the end. I watched the kick to win the game.
I think
it was a really good game.
There's only one more game in the preseason, then they shut down for 2 weeks and get ready for the season, right?
One more game and then season start, yeah. One more game.
On September 7th, correct. Now, here's some stuff that's whirling right now, Pearly. NFL players' teams should be trying to trade for before the 2023 roster cuts. Here's the top five. Shaquille Barrett, edge, Tampa Bay Buccaneers. They're trying to save some money, you know? Now, here's something that the Cowboys jettisoned a couple of years ago. You all told me, hey, naughty, y'all letting Lael Collins go. Why? We knew why. Gone to Cincinnati, out of there. Now he's on the bench. But somebody in desperate need of an offensive lineman could actually make a trade.
I believe so.
And he's plug and play. As is number three on the list, Zach Ertz, tight end, Arizona Cardinals. If you need a tight end, that's somebody who could plug and play. Now here's something that interests me. Demarion Overshown, our number one, well, not number one pick, but a number four pick, first pick in the fourth round. Linebacker from Texas. 4.3 speed, was all over the place in the first preseason game. Blew out his knee in the second. They had him projected to start. Christian Kirksey, linebacker from the Houston Texans, is a good fit. He's 30, so he's getting toward the other side of the career. But he rushes the passer well, good in coverage on the tight ends, and tackles for a one-year rental. I think that might work.
It probably could work.
And then Logan Thomas, been injured a ton of times, tight end with the Commanders.
Yeah, that's his problem. He's hurt a lot.
But somebody rolled the dice and he could stay healthy. That might be a steal because he's actually kind of freakish at the tight end position when healthy.
When healthy.
So we'll see. We'll see some moves being made. And like I said, a lot still to be determined over the next couple of weeks. Because you got the 2 weeks in between the final preseason game. Some things could happen. Somebody who's out of football, Antonio Brown, arrested in order to pay a judge over missed child support. I hear you don't pay his team. He bought an Arena Football League team and didn't pay him.
Jesus.
He's just a real piece of work. So, Pearly, Jonathan Taylor. Think the Dolphins going to pull the trigger? You are the front runners.
I know. I don't know. But it depends on what Indianapolis want. You know, and then Jonathan wants to make more than Dalvin Cook, which is like eight, maybe close to $10
million. Yeah.
Is it really worth it, you know? Yeah, look at
you're
going
to have to pay him. He's in the last year of the contract. So at some point, you're going to have to pay the kid.
Next year, yeah. So it depends on what you're giving up for the one-year rental, if that's all it's going to be. Or are you going to give him the big money next year?
Yeah, that's something you all got to look at.
And
go ahead. Pearly, you still there or we lost Pearly? Mr. Producer, we got Pearly there. You got me on mute. You got me on mute.
You don't like that?
No, you just put me on mute, you know, and then...
No, I'm not on mute. You're not on mute.
We was talking for the longest. You can hear nothing what I said.
Oh, you are on mute. I got you.
Maybe I was on mute then. I don't know. But no, anyway.
I can't hear what you said. You on mute.
Who we got in the picks right now? Who you like in the picks tonight? All brought you across by the Allen game.
Of course, I had the Dodgers tonight over the Guardians. We were arrested. I like Tampa Bay over the Rockies. I like the Phillies to beat the Giants again tonight. I like the Yankees over the Nationals tonight.
I'm with you so far.
And I like the Orioles over the Blue Jays tonight.
And that one scares me. I think the Blue Jays might pull upset.
That one, I like the Braves to bounce back over the Mets tonight.
Yeah, that's a good one right there for sure.
Now, what's a good game to watch tonight? Houston and Boston. I wouldn't bet it, but I'll watch
it. Yeah, that's an entertaining game in the making right there. And you can bet all those picks Purdy put out there for you in the baseball right there on the islandgame.com. Go to their website. Go to their sports book. Bet it, set it, and forget it. Don't forget Percy's pension plan going on for you right now as well. All right, Purdy, we're going to get to the break. Flip side of the break. Colin Cowherd going to take us home. He's going to talk about the Baltimore Ravens, talk about the Washington Commanders, and talk about Jonathan Taylor on the trading block and potentially ending up with you guys, the Miami Dolphins. Y'all seem to be the front runner.
Oh, we'll see what happens.
That's a good pickup, Pearly.
That's a great pickup. You get that'd be a really good pickup. That would really help Tua, and that'll make the Dolphins
a strong contender. Yes, indeed.
Make the Dolphins' offense even that much more dangerous.
So we'll hear about that and more on the flip side of the break. Good stuff today, everybody who chimed in the first hour. Appreciate you, Pearly, in the second hour, and we'll do it again tomorrow, man.
Take time.
All right. Be good, Bahamas. We'll see you tomorrow. If you can't be good at it. Quick to the break. Out of the break, Colin Cowherd going to take you home. Let's go.
Cancer Treatment Centers of America is now City of Hope, creating one of the leading cancer care and research networks from coast to coast, providing more of what you need. More locations means more care closer to home. More specialists means more expertise. More research means more breakthroughs. More advancements means more treatment options. And more options means more hope. Learn more at cancercenter.com.
Attention all KFC lovers! Are you ready to get crazy on Tuesdays? Now you can get 5 juicy mouth-watering pieces of KFC chicken for only $10. It's crazy! 5 pieces of world-famous KFC chicken, handmade with a secret blend of 11 herbs and spices for only $10. Don't miss out! This crazy offer is only on Tuesdays and only at KFC. KFC Nassau. It's finger looking good.
What would you do with extra cash? Plan a trip.
Overhaul my wardrobe.
With CIBC First Caribbean, you can get comfy with savings on your mortgage costs. Buy or build your home or switch your mortgage to us and get up to US $1,000 off the loan application fee. Up to US $2,000 off home insurance. With up to US $10,000 towards switching costs, your pockets will be comfy too. Visit CIBCFCIB.com/get comfy for more information. Conditions apply.
We're going to give you a check every week for a year.
Percy's Pension Plan. Island Game, keep you with it. Percy's Pension Plan. Dream big, we will help you live it. Percy's Pension Plan. Island Game, we got you. Percy's Pension Plan. From the friends you can trust, it's winning is a must. Come play the game, you know, cause your best chance is with us. The most trustworthy name is Percy's Island Game. So put 20 on your account and ride this easy train at Percy's Island Game.
Okay, school bag. Books, pencils, uniform, oh Lord. And I gotta buy snacks too?
Just lay it on the line.
The Guardian Media Group and AML Foods want to help families in need with our first ever Back to School Snackathon. What's a snackathon? Well, we want to help by assisting in donating school snacks to children that may need them as they head back to school this year. To be a part of our snackathon, all you have to do is shop at your favorite Salomon Superstore or Fresh Market. At the store, you can donate your pre-existing loyalty points, or you can donate cash directly at the register. Every single penny will go towards purchasing snacks that will be donated for distribution by the Bahamas Feeding Network and Hands for Hunger. Together, we can ensure that every child that opens their backpack this year will have a snack and a smile.
Get involved, get involved.
The Grand Bahama News is available every Tuesday in the Nassau Guardian. Buy your local paper at Freeport convenience stores, Western Bakery, DeGregory's Fine Foods, and Bellevue Gifts. Want to reach your Grand Bahama customers? Then call Barefoot Marketing at 827-4578 or message them for ad rates via their Facebook page. Advertising opportunities now include classified ads too. Keep up with all the latest Grand Bahama news in the Nassau Guardian newspaper every Tuesday.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
I was locked on an NFL preseason game last night. The Ravens hadn't lost a preseason game since 2015, and I don't spend a lot of time breaking down preseason games, so this may be a first. But they lost last night, and I was watching that, and you know what I honestly believed? That NFL players care more about the preseason than NBA players care about the regular season. That's the message I keep getting. Bucks Sixers, TV Saturday. Nah, I played last night. My calf's a little sore. Ravens Commanders, all out war, all in. Leagues and players send messages through their effort, commitment, and style. Baltimore and Washington had me locked in for 90 minutes of the second half. I said this to my kids years ago. They were doing and participating in sports, and I said, I'll care if you do. The minute you don't, I'm out. I'm not a taxi driver or a Lyft driver or an Uber driver. The second you don't show passion, I got other stuff to do in the weekends. Trust me. And eventually, and they didn't care that much about it. And I was like, all right, they're good students. I'm good. They like to water ski and snow ski with dad. They don't want to play sports. I'm good. But the SEC for years is the college football conference I watch a lot because they care. The fans are crying. The cheerleaders are crying. The coaches are screaming. The announcers are all in. They care more, so I care more. I'm not from the South. I didn't go to Baton Rouge, LSU. I've been there once. Why do I care so much? If you care, I care. People for years have said football's popular because of the scarcity of games. It's not just that. It's an emotional investment. Careers can end at any time. By the way, we live in a very fractionalized world. People are on their phones and their social media, stuff I didn't have when I was a kid. And what gets you to a TV set? What gets you to the radio? What gets you places? If it feels really important and you can't miss it. The effort last night those two teams put in was significant. Why would I care? I'm not from the D.C. Baltimore area. This game doesn't mean anything. I wanted to say memo to the NBA. Have your players at least fake like they care about the regular season. The NBA commissioner is now creating a mid-season tournament so that his basketball players will care about playing basketball. It's a problem. It wasn't in the 70s, 80s, 90s. Maybe they're all so rich now. I don't know. I don't really care. It's not my issue. But last night was so great and so contagious and so fun. It's why we love this game. You care, I care. I don't know what the TV ratings were last night, but I could not have been the only person out here 3,000 miles away on the West Coast that was sitting there watching. I think Troy Aikman at one point said, this is the most fun I've ever had watching a preseason game. I got a little Sam Howell. I got a little Zay Flowers. OBJ didn't play, but they talked about him. I've never seen teams care more for a preseason football game. If you care, I care. It's that simple. Those men cared. So I was in. Here's a story. The Colts. This has gone back and forth, are now seeking a first-round pick for Jonathan Taylor. He was a second-round pick. I love that pick. He was terrific. But you'd have to sign him or trade for him and then sign him. It would be a lot of money. I don't know what his market is, but there's somebody out there that wants him. But let's just look, because I'm going to make a comp here. And I don't think I'm wrong. Look at the last 3 to 4 years at Indy. They fire Frank Reich, who immediately gets a great job and a raise from a really aggressive owner. They pulled the plug on Carson Wentz, despite the fact he had a 27 TD, 7-pick season, and a 96.5 quarterback rating. That's pretty good. They've now ticked off their star running back, the best player on their team. They hired a head coach straight from ESPN, Jeff Saturday, good guy, not an NFL head coach. Does it sound like a well-run business? Oh, by the way, they won't sign their best player, which you can argue a second contract even for a star running back can be tenuous, but they will spend $100 million on a guitar collection for the owner. You know what Jim Irsay's become? The James Dolan of the NBA. Dad gave him a fortune, a great business. He's gotten rich, and he's now distracted and loves his music. It's a problem. He's also the most active NFL owner on Twitter or X or whatever it's called. That's not great. For years, people questioned Irsay, but he had a grown-up in the room named Peyton Manning that kept it stable. And then he had Andrew Luck, Stanford IQ, no nonsense, kept it stable. The longer Peyton Manning and Andrew Luck, further away they get in the rearview mirror, the crazier and the loonier this franchise appears to be. 5 years, 8 starting quarterbacks. It is a problem. When you're a great franchise quarterback, it's like Joe Burrow in Cincinnati. You're a bit of a magician. You're showing us your right hand and all the greatness over here, and then it's distracting us for all the goofiness and the ownership problems and the executive suite chaos over there. It's a great magician. Burrow did it in Cincinnati. We didn't know if Zach Taylor could coach. It appears he can. The O-line was a mess. They didn't have an indoor practice facility in northern cold weather. They had a cheap owner. They didn't really have an official GM. And then a grown-up came into the room named Joe Burrow and solved all of it. And that's what happens in chaotic organizations. Maybe Deshaun Watson can solve the Browns, though I doubt it. But Peyton Manning did that for years. And then Andrew Luck did it for years. There's only so much a general manager like Chris Ballard can do. He's just an employee working for the boss. But a star franchise quarterback has the fans in their pocket too, and fans ultimately pay the owner. So Joe Burrow and Andrew Luck and Mahomes and Peyton Manning and Brady have real power, and the owner knows it. They move merchandise, they get you on television, and you benefit. What can a GM and a front office guy do? You know, you're running around at the behest of the owner. But this is a problem in Indianapolis. Another starting quarterback, Frank Reich, is gone. Carson Wentz wasn't great, but Carson Wentz was damn good for them. The Jeff Saturday situation, Jeff's a great guy, by the way, but that felt Looney Tunes. And now Jonathan Taylor. I've said before, you can make an argument that if Anthony Richardson is as good and productive athletically as most of us think he will be, sort of a Josh Allen, Cam Newton, that you could move, he's going to gobble up Jonathan Taylor's yards anyway, you could move Taylor if you could get a great corner and a receiver. There's an argument to be made. There is,